Welcome, everybody. This is the start of the 2011-2012. Yes. Well, that's okay. I just wanted to get to the Mayan calendar a lot faster is all, you know.
Yeah, we're not going to make it fast.
So, basically, we're going to run over the rules really quick. Everybody pretty much understands the general sportsmanship rule. It's been the same for 127 years. It should not, you know, just be cool to everybody. Don't yell at me if I make a boo-boo because I, you know, it's not my whole life, this hockey league. Abandon teams to ensure maximum enjoyment. For all participants, each owner is required to participate weekly throughout the season. If an owner does not contact the league commissioner or does not place a lineup each week after the season begins, that team will be considered abandoned for that week, of course, and that owner will lose one transaction per missed week. Okay? So, league will give only one warning, and being me, the league, blah, 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 you know where that's coming from. Let's see, trade is officially opened as of 11 o'clock today, I believe. Trading, today is draft day. Let's see, trade deadline, March 3rd, 1 p.m., okay? This year it's a little earlier, all right? Let's see, franchise players, everybody knows that, player salary and positions, we got that covered, right? Let's see, draft order, we basically have that all set. You guys know how we do the draft order. Non-playoff teams get a little lottery. If you get your butt kicked in the first round, the four teams go in order of where they were regular season, and then you're like me and Todd and Trav, who have to draft at the end, you know, because, you know, you make it to the finals. It sucks. team rosters, we were talking about that earlier, 10 forwards, 7 defensemen, 3 goalies, 3 extra skaters, and the minor league players. Team roster cannot exceed $65 million. That's an increase of $5 million. Please don't spend that on just one player. Regular season lineups, 9 forwards, 6 defensemen, 2 goalies. Quick note, teams are allowed a 54% roster change throughout the regular season. That's 13 players moved in trades to the minors, released, or lost to waivers. Transactions, everybody gets 6. That's been for 100 years. You make a trade involving first and second round pick, they cost you a transaction. Player movement, free agents, trades, sending players to the minors, claiming players off waivers, releasing players. We know everybody understands free agents. Anybody not picked, still out there in the free market, is a free agent. We shouldn't have to go over that. Right? Right. The trade rules have not changed. I think it's now 3 years. So unless I need to go over it, we're good, correct? Sounds like it. Nobody's saying anything. Minor leagues. Teams can move players to the minor leagues for 10% of the salary. Before the player is allowed to be moved to the minor leagues, he must clear waivers. Waivers is 1 week. Teams can move no more than 8 players into the minors. Okay.
Is there a cap on how many goalies you can have in the minors?
There is 3. Yes, 3. I believe, right? I have that somewhere. Yep, maximum 3 goalies right there. Yes, waivers, players that move to the minors are on waivers. We just talked about that. They cost 10% of their actual salary. Simple enough. Just take a 0 off the end, and you know what he costs in the minors. Releasing players cost a transaction. The only time it does not is before November 1st if the player hasn't played in the NHL. Okay, or I even allow if he's played like one game, they sent him out of there, and he's gone out of the NHL
by November 1st.
You can take him off your books, just outright release him, and you're not stuck with him. Okay, that's I think the second year on that rule, which is something probably most people didn't know. That means if Ryan Getzlaf breaks his leg after draft and he's gone for the entire season, you can just dump him. Okay. Hopefully I didn't jinx you too much. You know. Categories, same for 100 years. Category points, the same. Playoff points are the same. I wanted to touch back on the draft a little bit here. Everybody knows that at the end of draft, if you want to throw a guy in the minors, if you had the money, you can do that. All right? And we're going to go in the same order. Yep. One guy. Right. And he can't. And it's the guy you draft as the minor league player. You can't just bring that guy in and throw a guy down. That will actually cost that guy to go on waivers, is what it will do. Okay. Blah, blah, blah. What?
So if you're at the end of the draft and you have $6 million, you can just draft an extra guy for the minors? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. Right. If you have that kind of money, yeah, we all.
Even if you have $300,000, you can get a $3 million player.
Right. And throw him down there. Right.
Because you're only paying 10% of the minors.
Oh, okay.
Well, that's, you go straight to the minors. If he's $3 million, he only costs you $300,000.
Right, and that's the only time it won't cost you to pick up an extra guy.
All right.
So I suggest utilizing it, okay?
It goes according to draft order.
Right.
Right.
According to draft order.
It's like an extra round, basically.
Playoffs have changed, okay? Playoffs, top team in each division plus next five teams. Since there's 10 of us, we're going to we may modify. Huh?
Is that official?
What?
Right,
10
teams.
Right. Jeff is not here.
They're in the draft right
now. If you'd heard, listen to me earlier, I'm going to let him get here till 11 o'clock.
Okay.
All right, when we actually start the draft. Right, okay. Let's see. Next five teams would be if we had the 12 teams. We'll discuss how we want to modify. I still say the eight teams because we expected it, but we will have to decide how we're going to do divisions. And that we can do as I don't really care. We just figure it out. And really the only two options are two divisions or one giant conference. Okay? That's really the only two options I see.
Let's decide right now.
All right. Let's go down starting from Roy.
Two divisions?
Okay, let me state, if we do two divisions, then it's going to be four teams a division make the playoffs. That's the way I see it. And you have to play within your division to get out. That's the way I would do. That's the way I see you would play instead.
Top four for each division.
Right.
One team.
Right. So basically, they're conferences is what happens.
Yeah.
And you play.
From each conference.
Right. We had a 10-team league a long time ago for 2 years, and that's exactly how we did it. You played within your division,
okay,
and that'll really affect trading towards the deadline if you have to play within your division to get out of your conference. Each conference will have a champion to go to the finals, is what.
Okay, so it would no longer be the 1 seed versus the 8 seed, it would be the 1 against the 4 in each conference.
Right, 1 versus 4 in each conference. I'll propose something after the first break, and you guys, we can adjust from there, all right? Okay, so playoffs. Playoffs are different. So now that we got that set up, there are best of seven now. They're not a best of five. Okay, so each round is a best of seven. Okay. Let's see. Each game is 2 days worth of NHL games, just like always, all right? Every round, every team's reseed within their division to get to the championship. Since we're going to two conferences, let's see. Playoff lineup: 7 forwards, 5 defensemen, 1 goalie. An extra skater can be used in shootouts. Okay. Also, this is a change with the shootouts. You have to list the order, and it's unlimited amount of players in the shootout. They're going to go 1-1. If that's still tied, then it's going to go 1-1 to the next guy, 1-1 to the next guy, and you're just going to go right down the list. So depth is important, okay? And because depth is important there, we are also making it so as soon as the playoffs start, you can call up all your minor league players, no cost to your team on salary, nothing.
No,
it's just
player restrictions on how many players are on your roster if you call up Let's say you got eight guys in
the like the NHL. They
send down eight.
No, there's no send down in the minors. It's just strictly call everybody in your minors, if they're on your team,
is available to use.
It, just like the NHL, when they allow the players to be called up for the playoffs, that's the same thing. So there's no penalty. The penalty for the players going to the minors is during the regular season, and that's when you can get them grabbed from you. This way, there's no waivers in the playoffs. It was a pain in my ass last year with the waivers in the playoffs. So. So, do we got that? Okay, no question. Anybody in your minors, soon as the playoffs start, so you don't have to call them up 2 weeks in advance, okay? You can ride out your good players, you know, and just call up your crap later, you know, because that I think that affected standings a little bit. Right, home ice is the very last thing, but this way, if you just keep going, skater number one shootout. If there's still a tie, then we go to skater two, skater three, and there will be. We need that order in that. Okay, so and those players cannot be in your starting lineup. They are separate players. Okay, so that depth is a big thing. All right, go and get as many players you can. As you can, you know. So. That would be the way to grab, and since we can only have eight, that's your maximum amount anyways. You know, and chances are it'll probably be four or five players at the very high end. Yes?
He's a czar, but I forgot
what he is. If they automatically come up, say I got a goalie in the minors.
Mm-hmm.
He's had multiple offenses.
They automatically come up.
That's the one downfall. Yes. If you have no goalie, then yeah. That is the one small downfall to the whole thing is that you have that. So you may want to get near the deadline, trade off some player that you don't want to get stuck with, you know. Or right, if you have a way to outright release them, dump them. Because the transaction deadline does go will go longer this year as well. Not the trade deadline will be done, and we're going to let the transactions go right up until the very end. Okay? So I'm giving you some, and I'm taking a little bit away. But I think I'm giving a lot more this year with the higher salary cap and stuff like that. So playoff lineups were good. Let's see. Shootouts, we've already covered that, right?
Mm-hmm.
And home ice advantage, that's different. Best of seven, highest seeded team gets first two games, lowest seeded team gets next two. Highest seed, lowest seed, highest seed. That's how it goes. Just like the NHL. 2-2-1-1-1. Okay. Team revenue is all the same. Playoff money is all the same. The monthly schedule is going to be the last official day of the month. So if a week, say October 31st is on a Thursday, Sunday will be the payout for that month. That Sunday will be the payout for that month.
Ice time,
okay.
Ice time, ice time, ice time's on. Ice time, ice time, ice time, ice time's on.